Today's COD history video is powered by the free Booster and GFX app for Call of Duty Mobile. You can click the link at the top of the description and go download, or you can find the app in the Google Play Store by typing in the search bar Booster for COD M. There is a reason that 150 million people have downloaded the game. Maybe you want to play Call of Duty Mobile up to 60 FPS. Maybe you have a low-end device. Maybe your phone's not the best and you want to help reduce lag. This app can help you with both of those things. It works by temporarily shutting down the background processes of your phone. It cleans the RAM up and intensifies the processor performance, which can get you up to 60 FPS. And if you have a low-end device, it can help you play with less lag. But the app isn't just about performance. It also feeds you first-hand information about everything Call of Duty Mobile-wise. Characters, weapons, outfits, score streaks, pieces of gear, updates. You can even review your game stats from the competitive rank mode in the app. Plus, you can share all this content to Facebook, Twitter, and WhatsApp. It has a ton of other cool features. If you're a social player, you want to friend up in duos and squads, you can do that as well. And it has all the classic Call of Duty franchise game modes, including Call of Duty Black Ops, the original Modern Warfare series, and the Battle Royale mode in Call of Duty Mobile. It doesn't matter if it's solo, duo, squad, you can find a strategy that's best for you in this app. So there you have it, my friends, the exclusive Call of Duty Mobile Booster app for a better gaming experience, and heck, you can even get free HD wallpapers. Click the link in the description, go download it, check it out, let me know what you think. Let's get right into this. Some guns took skill in Call of Duty. That is the truth. And the first one was the Banshee in Black Ops 3. Now, this was the energy shotgun. Man, people were excited about this. This was added in supply drops in June of 2016. Likely in an attempt to prepare us for Infinite Warfare. And instead of being a hitscan weapon like most everything else in COD, the Banshee was a projectile. That's right, it fired a fat, slow-moving energy beam that would hit for precisely 101 damage, killing anyone it touched with a single hit. So, you have a one-shot kill gun with infinite range. Who thought that was a good idea, right? The gun is balanced pretty well by the fact that it's a projectile, so you have to lead your shots and anticipate enemy movement. So while you can cross-map someone hitting them in the toe, which is a little stupid on paper for a shotgun, it's actually really freaking hard to do, especially when everyone is running on walls and spamming breccies. It's a good way to start today's video. At number 9, the G3, all the way back in COD 4, the unsung hero of COD 4. Well, not really. In reality, it was just an underappreciated assault rifle. It was a semi-automatic assault rifle that would kill in 2 to 3 shots from most anywhere on the map. And with a fire rate cap as high as Snoop Dogg on Tuesday morning, you could really get some work done if you had a trigger finger, because COD 4 was dominated by guns like M16s, MP5s, RPDs. They just required a little bit of effort. But guns like the G3 often got passed over because it did require skill, and the awkward iron sights didn't help things. But once you got the red dot and figured out the timing for the reload and the fire cap, the G3 became one of the most powerful guns in the game, as you tagged people from across the map or ran up in someone's face and aggressively shook your finger at them. Now, if you still have Modern Warfare Remastered, I suggest just give the G3 a try. It's fun once you get the hang of it. At number 8, we have the Pharaoh in Black Ops 3. Now, many people have said the Pharaoh is a crap weapon, and all of those people, well, we're going to say they're wrong today. It was a 4-round burst submachine gun in BO3, kind of like a pocket M8. Because it wasn't a simple point-click-shoot weapon like most of the other guns in BO3, it actually required you put a little effort into it. Many people wrote it off, but if you knew how to make it work in your favor, you could dominate lobbies before your enemies would have time to complain about the connection. Now, the Pharaoh could hit for up to 35 damage per bullet, which made it possible to one-burst somebody and then take the extra bullet home in a doggy bag for later, and it was a juicy 40-round magazine by default. Now, this weapon really had a lot going for it, so let this be a lesson, okay? Don't write off weapons that just require a little bit of effort to use. At number 7, the Riot Shield. Now, this bad boy was first introduced in MW2, and has since returned in quite a few COD games. Now, many people think of the Riot Shield as just being a lame, trolley gimmick weapon, but it's actually very difficult to use effectively, and I'm sure we all know just how frustrating it is to go up against someone who knows what they're doing. Most Riot Shields in COD will protect you from the knees up, and if you know how to abuse the perks in each game, you can set up a class that allows you to use equipment really quickly or swap weapons with ease, which allows you to bait someone in, make them burn a magazine, and then throw a knife in their ear hole while they're reloading, or just run up and give them a little love tap and watch them fall over as if someone had just bumped them while opening a car door. The Riot Shield is tough to use effectively. That's why it's on this list. At number six, the MK2 carbine in Modern Warfare. Now, there's something awesome about lever action rifles. Call of Duty doesn't have much of a history with lever actions, mainly because we've never had a COD game set in the Wild West. That would be awesome, but Modern Warfare gave us a pretty good one in the form of the carbine. This marksman rifle holds 6 shots at a time. It will fire very quickly, which allows you to get really quick follow-up shots. Plus, if you aim high, you can one-shot people with ease. The MK2 carbine has been a popular choice for aggressive snipers in MW, and it's, PC, if you're on PC, it's easier to jump around corners, snap to people's heads. This thing's a monster. It makes them uninstall before you alt-tab out to order the pizza on your second monitor. Cracking into the top 5. The KSG in Black Ops 2. Now, it's somewhat rare for Call of Duty to include a shotgun that actually takes skill. I'm not saying shotguns take no skill to use. What I'm saying is if you use shotguns regularly, you're probably also the kind of person to blame lag every single time you die. But the KSG really was the first time a Call of Duty shotgun demanded more of you than just walking around pressing a button like a ride operator at a theme park. The KSG demanded you actually aim down the sights. It demanded you actually track your targets properly because it was a slug, not buckshot. And while it rewarded you handsomely for landing your shots, if you didn't use it correctly, well, it didn't help you, okay? It can be hard to have a higher risk, high reward weapon in a game like Call of Duty where the whole experience is designed to not scare anybody away, but the KSG hit the sweet spot of being frustrating to use, but still worth your time to practice with. And then again, this was 2012 when Activision still cared about skill being a main factor in Call of Duty. At number 4, the Ballista in Black Ops 2, despite quick scoping being a thing since COD 4. I think we can all agree, it was kind of janky until around Black Ops 2. COD 4's quick scoping was definitely odd due to the lack of quick draw. MW2's quick scoping was better, but still felt inconsistent. In Black Ops 1, well, there was no quick scoping, okay? Modern Warfare 3's quick scoping was once again fun, but somewhat inconsistent. Then BO2 rolls around with the buttery smooth hit detection and more balanced selection of sniper rifles, and this is where quick scoping finally made its full potential. The Ballista was the main weapon of choice for most aggressive snipers in BO2, thanks to its handling and fast ADS time, but the trade-off was a rather small one-shot kill range. So to kill someone with a single hit with the Ballista, you had to hit someone in the head or the upper chest, meaning you couldn't just throw on stopping power and hit someone in the foot like in Modern Warfare 2, and the slow rechamber time meant you couldn't spam someone like Modern Warfare 3. So my point here is, while quick scoping has been part of the COD community since long before BO2, you could even argue that it was better before Black Ops 2. Black Ops 2 was the game that really nailed the system down and showed us. It showed us what it's like to be consistent, powerful, but still demanding precision and practice. Sticking with sniper rifles at number 3, the Locust in Black Ops 3. Now, for this entry, take everything I said about the Ballista, but add jetpacks and delete the aim assist for some reason. Sniping in Black Ops 3 was hard, and that's what made it all more satisfying when you did it well. And when making BO3, Treyarch decided to get rid of the aim assist on sniper rifles. I'm assuming the aim assist beat them in a 1v1 as well. Then, just to sprinkle salt on your finger wounds, they added jetpacks and wall running, and sniping was really freaking difficult in Black Ops 3. Some would even argue they went too far with the sniper nerfs, but this actually led to a brand new showing of skill. Quick scoping with the Locust with advanced movement and no aim assist. And it still blows my mind that people were able to do this so well. And watching montages of people jumping around walls and dominating lobbies with only the Locust, well, it makes my fingers hurt just thinking of the time it must have taken to get that movement down. So what I'm saying is if you're good at quick scoping in Black Ops 3, you're not a real person. You may need to get your hands replayed. At number 2, the crossbow in Black Ops 2. It debuted in Black Ops 1, and you may be confused as to why I'm not putting that one on here because the Black Ops 1 crossbow was kind of crap. I loved it, but when's the last time you actually used it? It fired slower than narcoleptic muskets, and while it had a generous blast radius, it wasn't enough to make up for the amount of bullet holes that would surely be added to your stomach by the time it went off. But now let's fast forward a couple years to Black Ops 2. The crossbow has returned and been reworked, and it's not only fun, but it's actually viable in a public match. Go figure. Crossbow now fires faster, can hold 3 shots at a time before needing to reload, and while the explosion has been toned down, the increased fire rate, it made up for it. It also fires projectiles that have travel time and drop, meaning you had to really know your angles if you were going to hit people from range with this thing, making it all the more satisfying when you did. And at number 1 today, the ballistic knife in Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2. There's really no logical reason why a trained soldier would run into a battlefield with what is effectively a slingshot on steroids, but then again, this is COD. For a series that tried to be realistic every year, there really isn't a whole lot being passed around in the multiplayer. But enough of that, let's talk about the ballistic knife, a fan favorite weapon that debuted in BO1 and made its great return in Black Ops 2, then it was bastardized in Black Ops 3 and 4. The special weapon would fire a projectile, complete with travel time and drop, meaning you had to take the angle into account, as well as lead your shot, and it would reward you with a satisfying one-hit kill from any distance. Now, glossing over the fact that a knife to the foot from 100 meters away instantly kills someone is perhaps the dumbest thing in any Call of Duty, but it still became a fan favorite because it was fun to use, and it took skill to perform consistently with. The weapon returned most unchanged in Black Ops 2, and you could do cross-map stabbing, but then it came in Black Ops 3 supply drops after the NX Shadow Claw had already moved all of its purpose, and then once again brought back in Black Ops 4 as this spammy, no-skill, multi-kill DLC weapon. So, I'm sorry if I sound bitter about this, but Call of Duty just had this annoying habit of bringing back fan-favorite weapons and ruining them somehow. But it took skill, okay? Back in the day, this one took skill. That's why it gets the number one spot. You let me know one weapon that took skill that didn't make this list, and tell me in the comment section. Once again, guys, today's video was sponsored by the free Booster and GFX app for Call of Duty Mobile. The link is up at the top of the description. Go download it for free and give it a try.